How is everyone? How is it going? Hope that all of you are staying at home safely and enjoyed this Eid al-Fitr, right? So students, can you hear me properly?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
In my Google Classroom, I submitted assignment 1. Do you know that? Today at
Yes, ma'am.
8 a.m. I submitted your assignment 1 and you have to submit the answer copy
8 a.m.
within tomorrow 8 a.m. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
And some instructions for you that you have to write down your name, your ID number and signature at the bottom of each page. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. So, today we will learn how can we apply the formula of Fourier transformation to solve the numerical example, okay? So our main goal is to use Fourier transform for finding or solving any numerical example. But before that, I want to say something about your assignment. Suppose a function, if can you see the board properly?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Suppose I give a function f of x is equal modulus of x, okay? So in that case, you have to divide. You have to express your function into piecewise function. Suppose a function f of x is equal this given, and I ask to find the Fourier series of that function, okay? This problem is related to your assignment, that's why. And at first, you have to convert this equation into piecewise, you know that, into piecewise function. You know that here, modulus of x means it is plus x when x is greater than 0. And modulus of x means minus x when x is less than 0. So from this function, you can derive this piecewise function. Now you will be able to convert this function as like your previous knowledge, okay? So this is one information about your assignment. When your function is f of x is equal like this, and you have to convert it into piecewise functions. And after that, you will be able to complete this math by using your previous concept. How can we solve or we express a piecewise function into Fourier series? And the another one, which is also related to your assignment, suppose I told you to prove that x into pi minus 2x is equal here cos n pi x or something like this, okay? Suppose I told you prove that this is equal this. In that case, you also have to use Fourier series. You have to use Fourier series, and here your function will be this. Here, the expression on the left side, you have to consider this as your function. At first, consider f of x is equal this, and now expand this function into Fourier series. And here, there is a term on the right side, cos n pi x by 2. Since on the right side it is cos n pi x by 2, then you can complete your proof by using half-range Fourier cosine series, okay? Since on the right side your term is cos, so for this math you can use half-range Fourier cosine series. If I prove, asked you to prove this is equal sine n pi x by 2. So here you have to consider your function as like x pi minus 2x, and you have to use half range Fourier sine series since on the right side the term is sine. Okay. And another thing, if I ask to find the Fourier series of a function which is a multiple of x which will represent x plus x square in the interval. Suppose I give you a problem, find the Fourier series of the multiple of it, which will represent x plus x square in the interval minus pi less than x less than pi. For such type of problem, you have to use your previous concept of Fourier series expansion, but here in that case, you have to consider your function as x plus x square, okay? This is the new thing. Suppose I ask to find the Fourier series of the multiple of x, which will represent x plus x square in the interval minus pi to pi. And here you have to consider your function f of x is equal x plus x square. Okay, that's all regarding your assignment. Anyone, any problem to understand these three things? I discussed about three problems. Anyone, any problem to understand the basic idea of this problem?
Ma'am, last year question, multiple f x.
Okay.
এখানে আমাদের তো তাহলে সবই বের করতে হবে, তাই তো? A not a and b n.
Yes. In that case, you have to derive the whole things a not a n and b n. After that, you have to substitute the result in your main formula.
Yes,
okay?
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. I think you got the point about your assignment. Now today I will go for our today's lecture. That is application of Fourier transform. Okay. I think all of you can see the board properly. Our today's problem is okay. So today's problem is find the Fourier transform of the function. One thing is that if anyone faced any problem to hear me or to see the board, please inform me directly. Okay. So the problem is find the Fourier transform of the function f of x is equal to this, and obviously the given function is a piecewise function, right? Here our given function is a piecewise function, and the first part is you have to find the Fourier transform of this function, and after that you have to evaluate these two things. One is minus infinity to infinity sine lambda a cos lambda x divided by lambda into d lambda. And the second one is 0 to infinity sine lambda by lambda into d lambda. So for this problem, at first we will find the Fourier here. F dot t means Fourier transform. Okay.
আজকে যেটা পড়াচ্ছেন সেই পিডিএফটা কি দেওয়া আছে?
Yes, last night I provided it. Basically, I was in a large pressure yesterday because I was suffering a problem in my laptop. I lost my hard disk of my laptop. So I think you can understand about my condition. So last night I have to prepare your lecture again. Basically, we prepare our lecture before 1 or 2 weeks. But since yesterday I lost my hard disk, that's why I have to prepare your lecture last night again. And last night I provided it in your Google Classroom. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So at first we will find the Fourier transform of the function f of x is equal to this, and after finding the Fourier transform, we will evaluate these two things. One is minus infinity infinity into d lambda, and the second one is 0 to infinity. Okay. So we will go for our today's math. At first, consider the given function, and this given function is a piecewise function, right? Okay. This is our given piecewise function. And all of you know that modulus of x less than a can be written, this inequality can be written like this, right? Modulus of x can be written minus a less than x less than a. And this inequality can be written minus x greater than a comma plus x greater than a, right? So Here our given function modulus of 1 comma modulus of x less than a can be written like this, minus a less than x less than a, and from this 1 will be minus x greater than a and another will be plus x greater than a. And from here f of x will be 1, this inequality minus a less than x less than a, and this inequality can be retained here x less than minus a. Is it possible to write down minus x greater than a is equal x less than minus a? If you multiply this inequality by minus 1, then it will be x and your inequality will be changed, right? When you multiply any inequality by minus 1 or minus sign or negative sign, then inequality will be changed. Here greater than will be less than, and this will be similar, x greater than a. So we get our considered function f of x. 1 for minus a to a, 0 for x less than minus a, and 0 for x greater than a. Suppose I'm considering, this is not a part of your maths, this is for your understanding, this part here. Consider the interval minus infinity to plus infinity, minus a to a, right? So here there is an interval, this is an interval, this is an interval. It is from minus infinity to minus a, and it can be expressed x less than minus a, right? Can you see the last line of the board?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Suppose here this part is only for understanding, okay? There is an interval from minus infinity to infinity and minus a to a. Now this is and one interval, this is our interval and this is a interval. Here we get three particular interval. One is from minus infinity to minus a, second one is minus a to plus a, and the third one is a to plus infinity, right? And this inequality you can write by x less than minus a. If you consider x less than minus a, then it means the inequality minus infinity less than x less than a, right? Minus infinity less than x less than a. These two are same thing. X less than minus a means minus infinity less than x less than minus a. Now go for the second one. You can write it as like minus a less than x less than a. Now for the last one, you can write it as x greater than a, right? So for x less than minus a, the inequality will be minus infinity less than x less than minus a. And for the range minus a to a, the inequality will be minus a less than x less than a. And for x greater than a, the inequality will be a less than x less than infinity, right? So from these three inequality, we get three open interval. One is from minus infinity to minus a, that is represented by x less than minus a. Second one is minus a to a, that is represented by this inequality. And the last one is a to plus infinity, that is represented x greater than a or a less than x less than infinity. This is for your understanding, not the part of your solution, okay? Now we get our function f of x is equal to this, and you have to apply the formula of Fourier transform. So by the definition, of Fourier transform. Here in the place of Fourier transform, I'm writing f dot t, but you have to write down Fourier transform in your answer script, okay? So if you use the formula of Fourier transform, then it will be, basically the formula was f of u is equal minus infinity to infinity f of x e to the power minus I u x into dx. This is the formula of Fourier transform for improper integral, right? This is the formula of Fourier transform for improper integral. And here, if you notice that there is the variable that is lambda, right? In your second part of this problem, there is a variable that is lambda. That's why here in the place of u, you will use lambda. So in the place of u, we will use lambda. This is the formula of Fourier transform for our considered problem. That is f of lambda minus infinity to infinity f of x e to the power minus I lambda x into dx. Okay, so this is the formula of Fourier transform. Now here there is a the interval improper integral interval is minus infinity to infinity. Now we will divide this whole interval into three sub interval. The first one will be minus infinity to minus n. Okay, the first one will be minus infinity to minus n, and you have to write down this part f of x e to the power minus I lambda x into dx. The second interval will be, can anyone say what will be the second interval?
Minus a to infinity.
It will be minus a to a, f of x e to the power minus I lambda x into dx. And the third one will be a to plus infinity, f of x e to the power minus I lambda x into dx. Okay, so now you have to find the values of f of x for the interval minus infinity to minus a. The values of f of x for minus a to a, the values of f of x for a to plus infinity. And you will get the values from this equation. Okay, so what is the values of f of x for minus infinity to minus a? Can anyone say from this function? From the function f of x, can anyone say what is the value of f of x for minus infinity to minus a? Here x less than minus a means minus infinity, less than x, less than minus a, right?
Zero.
For this interval, we can consider f of x is equal what?
Zero, ma'am.
It will be zero. So for the second one, minus a to a, here this is the interval, f of x will be 1, right? For the interval minus a to a, the values of f of x will be 1.
Yes, ma'am.
And for the last one, what will be the value of f of x for the interval a to plus infinity?
0, ma'am.
It is indicated by x greater than a, and the function will be 0. So for the first part or the first integral, we get f of x is equal 0. If you said f of x is equal 0, then the whole term will be
0.
Zero,
the
man.
Whole term will be 0.
Zero,
and for the second one, it is minus a to a, f of x is 1, this right? One.
Yes, ma'am.
To the power minus I lambda x into dx. And for the last one, the function zero. F of x will be 0. Since f of x is 0, then the whole integral will be 0. So we get minus a to a e to the power minus I lambda x into dx. Now we can easily integrate this integral, right? And the result will be e to the power minus I lambda x divided by minus I lambda. Okay. And you have to use the upper and lower limit. So it will be 1 by minus I lambda e to the power I lambda a minus e to the power I lambda a. Okay, can you see the last line?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, can anyone know what is the formula for e to the power I theta?
Cos theta plus I sine theta.
Yes, cos theta plus I sine theta, and it is known as Euler's theorem. Okay,
ma'am, Fourier transform e tinta alternative silo.
Yes, there are three formula, right? And now the question is why we are using this formula, okay?
Yes.
If you take a look in your problem, then you can say that in the second part that you have to evaluate two things, right? and in that case the given range is minus infinity to infinity, that is improper integral, and for this reason we have used this formula. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so the formula e to the power I theta, basically it is known as cos theta plus I sin theta, and it is known as Euler's theorem. And here in the last line you can see that e to the power minus I lambda a minus e to the power I lambda a, and for the part e to the power minus I lambda a, e to the power I lambda a, we will use this formula. Okay, then for e to the power I theta is equal to this, and e to the power minus I theta is cos theta minus I sin theta. And for e to the power minus I lambda a, consider lambda a as theta. Then what will be the result for e to the power minus I lambda a? It will be cos minus lambda a minus I sin lambda a, right? And for e to the power plus I lambda a, it will be cos lambda a plus I sin lambda a. Is there any problem to understand up to this part of this math? Now you have to use these two formula here. In the last line, you have to use these two formula, and it will be minus 1 by I lambda. And in the place of e to the power minus I lambda a, we will use this formula. It will be cos lambda a minus I sin lambda a. There is a negative sign, and e to the power I lambda is equal to this. So it will be cos lambda a minus I sin lambda a. Got it or not? Is it clear or not? Is there any problem to understand up to this part of this math? I think it's okay, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So here this and this will cancel each other, and from here you will get I lambda into minus 2i sin lambda a. These two negative signs will cancel each other, and here the imaginary unit will be vanish. And the rest part will be 2 sin lambda a divided by lambda. Okay, the rest part will be 2 sin lambda a divided by lambda.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am, why that imaginary part will be cancelled?
Here there is a unit, imaginary unit in the lower part, and there is an upper part, that's why you can cancel. Here in this part it is I lambda, okay, and in the upper part there is an imaginary unit, so these two can cancel each other, nothing else. Got it?
Yes, ma'am, yes.
Okay, so this, but here this result is for lambda not is equal to 0, right? Is it possible lambda is equal to 0 here? Then it will be infinite, right? Then it will be infinite. So here the condition will be lambda is not is equal to 0. But what will happen for lambda is equal to 0? Now we'll derive for the function or Fourier transform of f of x when lambda is equal to 0. Our formula was f of lambda is equal minus infinity to infinity f of x e to the power minus I lambda x into dx, right? It was our formula of Fourier transform. Now if you say lambda is equal to 0, lambda is equal to 0, then it will be e to the power minus I lambda x. Here it will be e to the power 0, that means 1, right? So it will be e to the power 0. And the rest part will be f of x dx. Now you have to calculate as like the previous one. You have to divide the whole interval into three sub-intervals. One is minus infinity to minus a f of x dx. The second one is minus a to a f of x dx. And the third one is a to infinity f of x dx. So as like our previous one, for the first one, the result will be zero or non-zero?
Zero.
For the first one, the result will be zero. For the second one, minus a to a f of x is 1 into dx. And for the last one, the result is also zero as like a previous experience, right? So here the result will be minus a to a. That means a plus a is equal to a. So when lambda is equal to zero, f of lambda will be 2a. So we find our Fourier transform of the function f of ax when lambda is equal to non-zero and when lambda is equal to zero. That means we complete our first part. So first part is complete. Our first part is completed, right? Now we will go for the second part. What is this? Basically, we have to evaluate two improper integral for the second part, right? This is our first part. And now we will go for the second part. And for the second part, you have to use, in the first part, we use Fourier transform formula. And for the second part, you have to use the formula of inverse Fourier transform, okay? What is this? For the second part, we will use inverse Fourier transform. We completed our first part, and our second part is, you have to evaluate, let me write down the problem again. Okay, this is our second part. We have to evaluate these two improper integral, and in that case, we will use the formula of inverse Fourier transform. There is a relation between the formula of Fourier transform and inverse Fourier transform. When you use f of u is equal minus infinity to infinity f of x e to the power minus I u x dx. If we use the formula, this is the formula of Fourier transform, right? And if you use this formula as Fourier transform, then your inverse Fourier transform. Inverse Fourier transform will be f of x is equal 1 by 2 pi minus infinity to infinity f of u e to the power plus I u x into dx, into du, okay? So this is the inverse Fourier formula. And here the variable is lambda. That's why we will replace u by lambda, okay? Here you have to integrate with respect to lambda. That's why in this formula, we will replace u by lambda. I'm repeating again, this is the formula of Fourier transform. And when your Fourier transform is this, then your inverse Fourier transform small f of x will be 1 by 2 pi minus infinity to infinity f of u e to the power, where if you use minus in the Fourier transform, then you have to use here plus in the inverse Fourier transform. That means e to the power plus I u x into du, that, and here you have to integrate with respect to u. But in our problem, you have to find the improper integral with respect to lambda. That's why here we will replace u by lambda, and the formula will be f of x, 1 by 2 pi, minus infinity to infinity, f of lambda, e to the power I lambda x into d lambda. Okay, so now for the second part, we will use this formula as the formula of inverse Fourier transform. Have you got the idea why we will use this formula here?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, by the definition, we can write the inverse Fourier transform as f of x is equal 1 by 2 pi minus infinity to infinity f of lambda e to the power I lambda x into d lambda. Okay, now we will consider this whole part. This consider whole part in the left side, it will be 1 by 2 pi minus infinity to infinity. And one thing is that, can anyone say what is the value of f of lambda here? when lambda is not is equal zero. When lambda is not is equal zero, what is the value of f of lambda? Can anyone say?
From the result of the
first part. It is the result of first part. So from our first part, we find f of lambda is equal to sine lambda a divided by lambda, right? I think this is the right. Into e to the power I lambda x into d lambda is equal f of x. Okay. So in the left part, 1 by 2 pi minus infinity to plus infinity. And these two and two will cancel each other, right? So we get 1 by pi sine lambda a divided by lambda. And here e to the power I lambda x. E to the power I lambda x can be written cos lambda x plus I sine lambda x into d lambda. And f of x is 1 when modulus of x less than a. Can you see the last part of the board? 1 comma modulus of x less than a? No.
No, ma'am.
Okay, then I have to write down it again. And here e to the power I lambda x can be written cos lambda x plus I sine lambda x into d lambda, right? And on the right side, f of x is 1 modulus of x less than a and 0 when modulus of x greater than a, right? Okay. So now take this 1 by pi to the right side. If you take 1 by pi to the right side, then it will be pi comma zero, right? Here there is a term 1 by pi, and if you consider this pi to the right side, it will be pi comma modulus of a less than modulus of x less than a and 0 comma modulus of x greater than a. Now here we can write sine lambda a into cos lambda x divided by lambda into d lambda, right? Plus minus infinity to infinity sine lambda a by lambda. Here there will be I, that means the imaginary part from here, into sine lambda x into d lambda. I think you can see the last part, right? And on the right side, it will be this pi comma modulus of x less than a, 0 comma modulus of x greater than a. So give concentration here. Here from this part, sine lambda a divided by lambda, if you multiply this with cos lambda x, then you will get this one. And if you multiply this for the imaginary part, you will get I minus infinity to infinity sine lambda a sine lambda x d lambda divided by lambda is equal to this. Okay. So this is our real part. If you consider the left part of the last line, here this is the left part of the last line. So here this is the real part and this is the imaginary part, right? Here this is the real part and this is the imaginary part. And on the right side, there is no imaginary part. Is there any imaginary part here on the right side?
No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
No.
Here the line is too large and the board is too small. That's the problem. Okay. So,
ma'am.
Yes.
আমাদের একজন ম্যাম মানে রোল 32 তার নেটে প্রবলেম হওয়ার কারণে সে ঢুকতে পারতেছ না ম্যাম যদি একটু
32 ওকে আই উইল কনসিডার হিজ অর হার অ্যাটেন্ডেন্স নো প্রবলেম ওকে সো উই গেট মাইনাস ইনফিনিটি টু ইনফিনিটি সাইন ল্যামডা এ কস ল্যামডা এক্স ডিভাইডেড বাই ল্যামডা ওকে ডিভাইডেড বাই ল্যামডা ইনটু ডি ল্যামডা দিস ইজ দ্য রিয়েল পার্ট রাইট And there is an imaginary part that is minus infinity to infinity sine lambda a divided by lambda sine lambda x into d lambda. And on the right side, it is pi and zero. and on the right side it is, yeah, this is equal pi when modulus of x less than a and zero when modulus of x greater than a. Okay, now if you consider the, or if you compare the real part from both sides, then what will happen? Comparing real parts from both sides, can anyone say? Here, this is our last equation. This is the real part. This is the imaginary part, right? For this I, and on the right side, there is no imaginary part. Now, if we make a comparison of the real part from this both sides, then what will happen? From left side, the real part is this, and from right side, the real part is this. So we can write minus infinity to infinity sine lambda a cos lambda x divided by lambda into d lambda. This is the real part from left side, right? And from right side, the real part is pi modulus of x less than a, zero modulus of x greater than a. So we get our first problem's result. Here, our first problem, sorry, not first problem, first problem of second part, that is minus infinity to infinity sine lambda a cos lambda x by lambda d lambda. Minus infinity to infinity sine lambda a cos lambda x by lambda into d lambda is equal to this. So we get the result of first problem of second part, right? Is there any problem to understand by how we can write this from our previous line? Anyone, any problem? Here we just compare the real part from both sides, okay? Nothing else. Is it okay or not?
It's okay, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now we will work for the second one, that is zero to infinity sine lambda by lambda d lambda, okay? And you have to derive the second one from your first one, okay? Now, if you want to convert these to zero to infinity sine lambda divided by lambda into d lambda, by how? You have to go there from here, okay? You have to go there from here. If you consider a is equal 1 and x is equal 0, then it is possible, okay? If you consider a is equal 1 and x is equal 0 in this equation, then what will happen? Consider this equation as equation number 1 or 2, something like this. So we will consider a is equal 1 and x is equal 0 in equation 1 for the second proof of second part. Right. Let's consider a is equal 1 and x is equal 0 in equation number 1. Then what will happen? It will be minus infinity to infinity sine lambda, okay? Here a is 1 and cos 0. Cos 0 divided by lambda d lambda. Now the problem is on the right side. What will be the result for a is equal 1 and x is equal 0? Can anyone say? No, I think it's tough. Here, our right part was pi modulus of x less than a and zero modulus of x greater than a, right? This is our right part. And we consider a is equal 1. So from this result, we get modulus of x less than 1, right? And it can be written minus 1 less than x less than 1, okay? It can be written minus 1 less than x less than 1. So for the second condition, if you draw the straight line minus 1 to 1, and here the value x is 0 exists or not? In this interval, x is equal 0 exists or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Exists, right? But if you consider the second one, that means x greater than a and a is 1. X greater than a and a is 1. X greater than a is 1, that means, okay, and it gives x less than minus 1 and x greater than 1. Now, if you draw a straight line here minus 1, 1, and x less than minus 1 means this part, right? And x greater than plus 1 means this part. Here x is equal 0 exist or not?
No, ma'am.
No, here x is equal 0 does not exist. So in that case, for the right side, you will consider only pi, because for x is equal, a is equal 1 and x is equal to 0, only the first interval exists. The second one does not exist. Have you got the idea? I think it's critical. So if you have any problem to understand this part, why we will consider the right side as pi, then you may ask. Okay, here it's quite difficult to understand why we will use only pi. I'm repeating again. Here, if you consider the right side pi modulus of x less than 1, it implies minus 1 less than x less than 1. And from here, x is equal to 0 exists. But for the second interval, greater than 1, it implies x less than minus 1 and x greater than 1. And here, x is equal to 0 does not exist, right? But we consider a is equal 1 and x is equal to 0. That's why we will consider only this part, not this. Okay? Anyone, any problem why we will use only pi on the right side? Okay, I think you got the point. So here cos 0 means 1. And this interval can be written 2 into 0 to infinity sine lambda cos 0 is equal 1 divided by lambda d lambda is equal pi. And finally, the result will be 0 to infinity sine lambda divided by lambda d lambda is equal pi. And here 2 will be on the right side, that is pi by 2. So we completed the second problem of our second part. Got it or not? Students, any problem?
Ma'am, limit 0 to infinity.
Okay, here your limit is minus infinity to infinity and the function is sine, right? And sine function, cos function, they are symmetric functions. And when your function is symmetric, then your whole interval can be written like this. Minus infinity to infinity can be written 2 into 0 to infinity. These two are same thing. Okay? Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So I think, and one thing is that these types of maths is very much important for your exam. Okay? So be careful about this problem. And I think all of you have written your ID number on the chat box, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Maybe all of you have written your ID number in the chat box. And also, we are at the end of for today's class. So students, stay at home safely. Allah Hafiz. And thank you for joining the class.
Ma'am, question chilo.
Yes, ask your question, please.
Ma'am, assignment je korbo, ma'am. Oita ki je kono kagoje korle hobe na, ma'am?
Yes. Mane
amra to scan korar jonno.
Only just you have to scan it in PDF form and send it in the Google Classroom. But it is must that write down your name, ID number and signature at the bottom of your of each page, okay? Not only the first page, of each page.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, any question regarding today's class or assignment one?
Ma'am, মানে প্রত্যেক পেজে নিচে নিচে নাম রোল সব লিখতে হবে
আর আচ্ছা
আমাদের ম্যাম 32 ক্লাসেস ছিল বাট নেটের কারণে শেয়ার অ্যাটেন্ড করতে পারিনি পুরো ক্লাসটি
ওকে আই উইল কনসিডার হার অ্যাটেন্ডেন্স অর হিজ অ্যাটেন্ডেন্স আই ডোন্ট নো আইদার হি ইজ মেল অর ফিমেল ওকে
ম্যাম
32
ইয়েস ম্যাম আমরা যারা এয়ার ফোর্সের ক্যাডেট আছি আমরা তো হচ্ছে একাডেমিতে আমাদের কাছে হচ্ছে ম্যাম 8টা থেকে 2:30টা পর্যন্ত হচ্ছে শুধু ল্যাপটপ আর নেট কানেকশন থাকে এছাড়া হচ্ছে আমাদের কাছে ম্যাম ফোনও থাকে না বা নেট কানেকশন থাকে না আমাদের যদি একটু অ্যাসাইনমেন্টের টাইমটা বাড়ায় দেওয়া হতো তাহলে একটু ভালো হতো
ম্যাম 8টা থেকে 2টা পর্যন্ত তাহলে আপনারা আগামী কাল 2টা পর্যন্ত টাইম নেন শুধুমাত্র যারা অফিসার্স তারা ঠিক আছে ম্যাম
আগামী কাল 2টা কালকে তো হচ্ছে আমাদের আবার ক্লাস আছে ম্যাম তো হচ্ছে আমরা ক্লাস
ইন দ্যাট কেস আই ক্যান নট ইনক্রিজ ইওর টাইম ইট ইজ ফিক্সড ফ্রম ইওর ডিপার্টমেন্ট ওকে সো ফর সাচ প্রবলেম ইউ হ্যাভ টু কমিউনিকেট উইথ ইওর হেড With your head of the department, you can communicate with your head.
Yes,
okay.
Yes,
if your department permit, then I can permit.
Yes,
ma'am. You got the point.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Okay.
Ma'am.
Yes.
For the assignment, do we have to write the question or only the solution?
It's better if you write down your question, right?
Okay.
I think it is not time consuming because the question is length of question is not too large. Okay.
Okay.
It's better.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you everyone for joining us today's class. Allah Hafiz.
Okay.